Bonjour, hello. This is Sebastian from SearchingAnxietySolutions.com, and I'm here with my friend Zizou.
Hey.
And I'm from SocialAnxietySolutions.com. I'm a former social anxiety disorder sufferer, and I help people overcome social anxiety so they can feel calm and relaxed in social situations. And today I'm interviewing Zizou on her social anxiety experience, how it was, how she experienced social anxiety in her area, and how she's kind of become more comfortable with herself. And the kind of things that she's done and how she's feeling now, and I'm sure she has some good tips and tricks for you. And this is very an impromptu interview, so we're sitting at the beach and she's like, oh well, is it gonna be question or answer? And I'm like, it's just gonna be in the moment, an interview, and we'll see how it goes. And so I'll give a little bit of a pre-story. So how we met is we met salsa dancing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I said to her, you're quite good for someone who just started. It's kind of like a half-assed compliment, but right? I said something along the lines.
Yeah.
And on those lines, and I said, I think that's because you're quite comfortable with yourself. Yeah. You remember or not?
Yeah. Totally.
Yeah. And what did you say?
So then I was like, basically no, not that much, because it's been a hard time for me since I started salsa. Like I met him maybe 3 months after starting, or like 2 months, and I said, yeah, like I maybe look more comfortable now, but it's been a hard time.
By the way, we're referring to salsa dancing, a Latin dance, just in case, some people really don't know what it is. So it's a Latin dance. Exactly. So you said something along the lines like that.
And then
I said, well, guess what work I'm doing? I'm a social confidence coach. I help people overcome social anxiety.
Exactly. You want me to share?
I'll say a little bit more. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I found it interesting. I'm like, wow, someone with social anxiety dancing salsa. That's quite like a step outside of your comfort zone. And I asked you about, what are the things that you've done that helped you be more comfortable then? All right. Mm. So, what's
then,
the answer, or what is
then
it?
I said, salsa helped me a lot. I've done some workshops, did some exercises to like step out of my comfort zone and push myself a little bit. And acro yoga also, like this kind of practices where we have like more contact, we're more exposed.
Yeah, because I don't know how much you want to share or how much you're comfortable with sharing, but what was your social anxiety experience like? So actually, because some people might watch this for the first time, so they don't know my social anxiety experience, so I'll just share like a few thoughts of how it was for me when it was at its worst, so you have a good idea. For me, I was super self-conscious. Like I would walk the newspaper. I was like, 14, 15 years old. I walked the newspaper and I'd start at the beginning of the street and I'd be like, oh, people are probably watching me. And I was even uncomfortable about, am I gonna swing my arms or am I gonna keep them next to my body? I blushed all the time. If I was the center of attention, I would blush. If there was talk about sex or dating or attractiveness or whenever I was the center of attention, I would blush. And as a result of that, I would get anxious a lot. And so my brain started fearing those experiences. So in the morning, when I would wake up, I'd already be scared of the people that I might run into that day. And there was gonna be an awkward situation. It was all like, I have to uphold this reputation that everything is okay and that I look fine and that I'm cool and that kind of stuff. And so that it was a very anxiety-ridden experience. So it really sucked and I couldn't overcome it. eventually I overcame it. Long story, if you want to hear about that, go check out another video or go here. I'll edit this in later. But for you, what was your social anxiety experience like?
Well, I've always been very shy and extremely introverted in class, you know. I was struggling by just asking questions or, when I was just in social events, I felt exposed, in all kind of situations, and, having an order in McDonald's or like this kind of things.
It would be difficult to order in McDonald's?
Yeah, it was all the time, always a kind of, I don't know how to say, une épreuve,
my French is failing.
Okay, it's
okay. I know
okay.
Like seven words.
Never mind, it was always a hard time, you know. I was okay, I'm gonna struggle this time, and again. It was like literally a nightmare every day, all day, because, I mean, you know, being around people and everything, that's what happened.
Yeah.
All day, every day, so...
And how would you feel on the inside? Like, what emotions would you experience, or how would it feel, or...?
Just discomfort, depending on the situation, but usually it was just kind of fear, feeling embarrassed, but for no reason, being stressed, having a knot in the stomach,
in the throat,
becoming red and sweating, like all these things, but depending on the kind of situation, right? So, basically it was kind of a mix of all these things. And I thought that by the time it would just go off, you know?
And it would go away on its own?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it didn't. And then I had some more issues, let's say, with men and with some other relations, with some other relationships, and all these kind of things. It just become worse and worse, and I could do pretty much nothing, you know. I tried to push myself and go to some events and start dating, all these kind of things, but I couldn't. Then I spent 5 years in Canada. It was a little bit better, but still I was still struggling and having a hard time every night, especially when I didn't know anyone. It was quite tough. Then I came to Bali last year. So my first 6 months here, it was kind of a reconstruction, and I didn't really try to go to talk with people, making friends or new relations, because I wasn't ready for this.
Yeah. What'd you do then? Hitting your room or?
Yoga.
Yoga.
Yeah, I came here for yoga.
Yeah.
So yoga all day.
Gotcha.
5 to 8 hours a day, it depends.
But 5 to 8 hours of yoga a day?
Yeah, yeah.
That's hardcore. Okay.
Was all yoga. I went back to Morocco, and because I'm from Morocco, I went there for summer, and I had a lot of expectations with my friends, because I had nothing for 6 months, it wasn't as good as I expected. So I said, okay, when I come back, I need to change. I need to make something. And so I started dancing, and I started acro yoga at the same time, 6 months ago again. Even more.
And how was that in the beginning? Because it's quite a courageous decision to make.
Well, I was passionate by all the Spanish and Latin culture, so it wasn't to help my problems or my issues. It was really because I was curious about this.
Oh, okay.
And then I knew it would be quite tough for me. But still, so I tried. I went to some social nights, and which is basically just nights where there's a live band or just DJ and me dancing. And it took me maybe 1 month and almost and a half to like just there actually go dancing in front of everyone, you know, because I was like, there was just no way for me to just go and pick up a guy and say, okay, let's dance. And like, I didn't know how to dance, I was shy and all these things. So yeah, but then Jorge, actually a good friend, was my very very first partner, and he just grabbed me one day and like we danced. It was awful for me. I mean, I loved it, but it was, I don't know what I was thinking about. It was just physically there. I mean, maybe I was thinking of all the people who were watching at me, looking at me, watching me, you know, because like we're just basically dancing in the middle of the tables and everything, so it's very embarrassing. I don't know how to dance, I'm missing the steps and all these things. So it took me maybe another month, a month and a half to like overpass this. That's where I met you, more or less. And we started dancing, and after a couple of weeks, I think that's when you told me, okay, you look comfortable. I don't know how we talked about this, but yeah, and then I said, well, actually, it's still hard for me, you know, to just, I mean, trying to get some attitude so then it doesn't show, but...
So that you show the outside world that you're comfortable, and the outside world thinks that you are.
Yeah, it's easier for me, because like if I just close myself and like nothing happens, it's really hard for me like to just overpass it.
So. Yeah, and so starting acro yoga, but anyway, acro yoga, what is it?
Yeah, so. So basically it's yoga and acrobatics, so we're playing with partners, one or more partners, and like there's a lot of contact, some tricky positions sometimes.
Is it sexual?
No, not at all, it's more sport, I'd say. Or hobby. It's like, it's kind of acrobatics, but you're like more gentle, you know?
People are lying on the floor, because we've actually done it on our retreat. Up for
I'm so sorry, it's all right
for her by her recommendation, so I took people from our retreat to an acro yoga class. People are lying on the floor, and then someone else is on top of that, and you know, flying and all that kind of stuff.
Exactly, so you have a base, you have a flyer most of the time, and or even more, and we're just playing
different poses with, and that kind of stuff,
body weight and everything. So there's a lot of fun, not just, there's a lot of connection, but it's mainly connection with the flyer. There's a kind of trust inside, because you're just upside down sometimes, or flying, or these kind of things. And a lot of contact everywhere, and we're most of the time, you know, in leggings and with shorts, and the men are topless, you know, so so it's quite intimidating. First, like on the first times, and also everyone's very good, like the girls are perfectly flawless, good shape, then same, and like you're coming and saying, okay, hi, want to try this. So yeah, it's quite intimidating too in the beginning, but it's really fun, and it's really worth it.
Yeah,
and actually it's the same. So how it helped me, well, I don't know what the process that happened, you know, but I remember on the first days or weeks, I was having a very hard time by just letting people, and especially men, touching me. Like nothing sexual, but just like the hips or the back. Was really, really hard for me to just let go. Either in acro or salsa, but more in salsa, because when you dance, and salsa or bachata, like all the Latin dance, because sometimes you have some tension, some sexual tension, even if you don't want to, but like just the dance allows this. So I was very uncomfortable. But then, like by the time, and by going there a couple of times a week, and also like making new friends, because it's most of the time the same people.
Yeah.
So we're just building more confidence, and like so some
familiarity, yeah, you know exactly. each other, yeah.
Totally, and so
similar interests. Mm,
and then it's easier, and then you just can let go more and more.
Right.
But still, so and then I went to India and I did lots of workshops, exercises. I traveled alone, and yeah, so I had no other choice than just like go for it, you know. But so can I talk about like the session we had?
Yeah, we'll get to that one second.
Okay.
Yeah. So what I want to point out is that we had Matt, and so she had social anxiety and shyness problems to a big degree, and so she didn't really know what to do. And so because she had an interest in yoga and dance, that's an area where she naturally was drawn to, and so she went there and she went a bunch of times, and she went over and over and over, and as a result she started to become more familiar with that and started to form some friendships, and that built some confidence, right?
Yeah.
So those are things that you can do. I've talked about that before because that's been my experience as well. Like when I go towards things that inspire me, that I like, that I enjoy doing, that builds some confidence, and the not just that it builds confidence, but it also builds like a social life. So connections, people that are like-minded, you run into the same people over and over, and it can be a bit scary or intimidating in the beginning, but as you keep doing that, the more and more you do it, the more familiar you become with them, and the more familiar they become with you. You start to recognize each other's name, and it's like, oh, that person is showing up again. And it's inevitable that you have some conversations with people, and people are generally nice. Yeah, maybe not if you're 12 and you're in, you know, some kind of a crappy school, but, you know, generally people are nice. If that hasn't been your experience, then unfortunately your past experiences are coloring your perception, and your perception is telling you people suck and they're going to be mean and that kind of stuff. That's something that you need to clean up, which you can do with energy and tapping, with energy psychology and tapping, and combining traditional psychology with energy psychology, which kind of brings us to...
Wait, just a sec.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay.
So yeah, I just want to, like kind of do a summary of what I said, or like give my advices, or what helped me the most.
Yeah.
So first thing is being part of a community, as you said, because like by watching, for me, that helped, like seeing more and more the same people. Like you create a kind of a confidence like in a circle and all these things. So, it helps, it's easier. And also try to do something you're very interested about or passionate about, because then like, this would bring the motivation of the motivation you'll have to do something you really want to or you really love will be stronger or bigger, overpass your stress or fear or anxiety or something. But like you're like, okay, I really want to do it. Either with salsa or acro, sometimes I was just almost crying, you know, because I was stressed and going there alone and saying, okay, what if no one wants to play with me? What if I just like I just go and I don't know, something bad, like I don't really know what's happening, but it's just like constant stress and anxiety. So like just by doing something that you love with a group that you see frequently, I think it's the best combo for me.
Yeah. For some people that's hiking, for some people that's martial arts, for some people that's playing football. Whatever, there's a variety of things, mountain climbing, yeah, exactly, there's lots of things. There's communities around everything right now. Just type in the thing that you're interested in Facebook, and then your city, and you'll find lots of groups that are interested in that kind of stuff. And if you're in salsa dancing, come salsa dance somewhere, and we'll meet up. Okay, so cool, so then... I had my retreat, and I invited some friends to come over to help out with, kind of, oh, I guess I'm going to reveal that with some salsa dancing. So the people on my retreat did some salsa dancing. It was with my favorite instructors, super comfortable class. It was very fun. And we needed some extra dancers. And afterwards, so Zizou came over. And then afterwards, we did a little group session. So I sat down and I tapped with everyone on their fears, their anxieties, and so on. And well, what was your experience of that?
Yeah, so so when I went there, all new people, but I came and they were already dancing because I came late as usual. So I just popped up by dancing and I was very okay because like now I have no more, thank God, no more issues by dancing, like in all situations with even with people that I don't know and everything. So I was really okay, and then so it was over and I said okay, so let's have a seat and do this workshop or exercise or like whatever you want to call it. And then I started to like stress because okay, now I'm gonna talk with people and I guess open a little bit myself and everything, and I wasn't really ready for this, even though I knew I was coming for this exercise, let's say. So yeah, I started to like close myself more and more, and we did this. So I think we started directly with the tapping.
Yeah, I actually, so I opened the little workshop space by saying, hey, we all, this is a retreat on social anxiety, and a lot of people experience anxiety, and we're now sitting in a circle, so, you know, we're gonna talk, you know, everyone's kinda express their feelings and tell me what's going on with you, and do you feel anxious right now in the moment? Normally that is something that everyone wants to hide, but this is a place where it's open, where you can talk about it. And we had a couple of people from the retreat, we had a bunch of people from the retreat, but we also had some new people into the group. And interestingly enough, you opened up, Iris opened up, saying, yeah, I feel anxious a lot, but I just don't let anyone know. You know, there's so many people socially anxious, just nobody really talks about it. It's this big secret. And
then when it was time to like just jump into it, I said okay, I'm really uncomfortable. I mean, but when I'm uncomfortable, usually I just laugh and yeah, like pretend everything is okay, but I'm just melting inside. So yeah, I just expressed clearly and honestly what was happening, and then we started to try to understand what was going on and how I feel it in my body and like where it's located, and imagine some situations and try to like, yeah, all this kind of exercises. We did this tapping thing where, I don't know if you talk about this on your on your channel, but yeah, like it was very new, and also like, and Seb was just, you know, tapping everywhere like this, and I was watching everyone doing this, but like normally, you know, like it was very natural. I was okay. We were like just tapping like this and talking. It was so embarrassing, but still I was okay. This might be part of the game. So yeah, and I don't explain. I cannot explain. I mean, it might have a explanation, but it just by the time helped me. Like I felt released, and like repeating some sentences. I don't really remember, but like was negative, I think, at the beginning, and then positive, but still tapping. And then, yeah, like I felt layers going out and going out. Also, we had to like imagine some situation where we would be embarrassed, and like I could see it very clearly, but like after maybe 1 hour of work, yeah, I just had, like it became, I don't know how you say it, but like when you don't see clearly,
fake.
Yeah, you know, and everything, and until almost like until it was gone, actually, like
until the emotion was gone.
The emotion and the vision I had when I closed my eyes and I tried to reimagine myself and these kind of things. So yeah, and then I was very surprised. I was okay, because actually you worked a lot on me on this book, maybe because I had to leave and so you put more focus on me, but still it was not even 1 hour and I felt the effect and I was okay, I don't know what is happening, but apparently this shit's working, yeah. So okay.
One second, let me explain it real briefly. So one of the exercises that we did, we all did tapping exercises, and one of the exercises that we did is I had her imagine a particular scenario that she would be afraid of. So I don't know, afraid of becoming embarrassed. I then had her imagine becoming embarrassed. And I think we came up with a past experience where she was embarrassed. And when she thought about that, you didn't even tell me what it was, by the way. No need to do it, but I'm just saying, because you can work even without content. And so we then worked, we rated her level of embarrassment on a scale of 0 to 10, and I think it was 8 or 9. Then we did the tapping, and afterwards, as always happens when you do it in the right way, that emotion shifts, it processes, it releases, and it's then no longer in your system. And so you feel different because you don't feel embarrassed anymore. You've processed some old emotions, some old emotional wounds have been healed. Emotions from younger yous that you were holding on to are no longer there, and so you feel more comfortable, you feel more at ease, you're more at peace with who it is that you are, and you've integrated a part of your past into your here and now being, and so you're more present.
Yeah. Well, that's very good said, but that's exactly what happened and how we feel it. So yeah, I was very surprised kind of curious about this method and how it works. And I think you proposed me to work on this, because like, yeah, I think I called him, or like I saw him a couple of days after that, saying, okay, like this thing is really magic, like it worked. And then like he proposed to do just session.
Yes, because you said that you have a particular bigger issue,
yeah.
And you told me that before the retreat already.
Yeah.
And I said I can probably help with that.
Yeah.
And since we were sitting in a group session, and I knew that was going to be something very personal, I said, you know, we'll meet one on one for that one.
Yeah.
That's how it went.
Totally.
Yeah.
So.
And then we met.
Well,
like,
I mean, I could. Talk about this also.
Oh like, yeah, share if you want to share. Great.
Yeah, I mean, I have nothing to hide, and I'm really glad and happy that it's not an issue anymore, or not as much as before. But yeah, it was like mostly with men and like sexually and in my relationships and my behavior with guys and everything.
What would happen?
What
would happen when the problem was there?
Like how
would you feel? Yeah.
I think just full of fear. It was like the most the biggest emotion that I could.
Biggest emotion that you could fathom.
Yeah.
Salsa's getting a bit loud, you know.
Yeah, so fear, and I would feel bad, like, I don't know, I just feel like I need to like open and open and open, and I feel compression in my chest, sometimes in my throat, on my belly, like all these things.
And what would trigger those feelings? Men in general, or?
It's really paradoxical, because on the other hand, I'm very comfortable with guys, like more than girls. I mean, most of my friends are men and everything, but I think as soon as there's this sexual tension, or like it comes around, I mean, all these things, yeah, like, because if it's full, if I feel comfortable with the guy, I mean, it's quite okay, but as soon as like we just shift, yeah, we block. And I could, I mean, I had some ideas, because like, you know, with the past, like there's some things that happen, and I can relate and say, okay, maybe it's because of this or this, but like I had no clue to just go like, oh, overpass it.
Overcome it.
overcome it.
You had no idea how to overcome it.
Yeah, like, right. Because, I mean, I was attracted, and like, there's so many men, and I would just watch them and say, okay, they're quite handsome, or hot, or attractive, or like, interesting, or never mind. And but then, like, I just couldn't go for it for months or even years, you know?
Yeah, because that feeling would get triggered, and then you close off, yeah. And you know, it's a no yeah. everywhere. Yeah.
So basically, this happened. Like, I always had this kind of troubles, but before I was young and I was okay. Maybe I was thinking it's because I'm young and I didn't want to like face this as a real problem. Then I had like a boyfriend. Like all the girls know, heartbroken, all these things. So for a year I was. Very I was still in love and not interested about in this. I wasn't into this at all, like for months
dating
and months.
Or boys
yeah.
or anything like
yeah.
that
mm-hmm. And then like 1 year after my breakup I was okay, time to move on and do something, you know. And then I realized I literally couldn't. I wanted to. I was attracted by guys, really gentle men, kind guys, like, you know, but yeah, for some reason I couldn't. And the more I waited, the bigger the problem became, and so I was just kind of lost. And salsa and acro helped me a little bit, but still I couldn't, you know, properly date or feel good in like my body, or like I don't know, but still this problem was still here. And so I talked with Seb, like the very first day when we talked about this, like when you said you're comfortable and everything, I said some issues with men, so when we were doing this exercise in the retreat, this workshop, of course I was thinking of this kind of situation, but also it's more general, like even socially I have lot of issues, but it's even worse with men, because socially, like sometimes I can feel really okay and comfortable, and I was at one point I shift and I can feel okay like with salsa and everything, but with men I would still have this boundary, you know,
this block,
yeah, huge block. And that's why you proposed me to do this private session, because I mean I think you guessed what might be the problem and everything. So we went for this session. It lasted the whole afternoon, like a couple of hours.
2.5 hour session.
Yeah. Or even more, you know, it's like really tiring for me, intense. We went very deep into the childhood and some problems that I could face. Have faced before. We got quite talked about some more intimate topics. So yeah, it was very hard for me. Like, I mean, I knew it was essential at this time and very important, you know, to like just open, because I was tired of the situation. But it was
emotionally challenging.
Yeah. Like I felt. Like mixed everything inside of my body and my mind, my brain.
Was it beyond what you could handle? Was it too much and you couldn't handle it?
I knew that we would go to this kind of things, because obviously like at one point we need to put the finger on it, you know.
Yeah.
So, and I know it would be like painful or like just disturbing, you know.
Yeah.
That's why I was very stressed actually before going to the session. We went almost beyond my expectations, because Kim talked about the parents and the childhood and some bad issues. So but I think I still could handle it. But I remember at the end of the session, I felt very light, fresh, released. I cannot explain why. I cannot. I don't know what happened, but it was just, I felt better, like instantly. I mean, during the process, no, but like as soon as we were into this more peaceful end and meditation, everything, yeah, I felt okay. Like I had no, I didn't want to cry and not anymore, you know. And
yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, and the two or three days.
Hold a second. Let me let me explain a bit.
Okay.
So, she's just an example of your issues. So, I mean, for everyone.
Yeah. Sure.
So, her particular situation was when she was with when attractive men would come up, she would get all these feelings in her body, in her chest, in her stomach, in her throat, and it would cause her to freeze up, and she couldn't be herself anymore.
Yeah,
am I saying that right?
Totally.
Yeah. So
like
anxiety.
You couldn't talk, or sometimes move, sometimes breathe. Like it's. Sometimes it could be very extreme,
right,
for no reason.
Right. And so that then is a big limitation in her life, because then she can't date, have relationships, get close, no intimacy. Those kinds of issues are caused by that. So it's these feelings and the anxiety. Enfin, you understand,
right?
My French. Anyway, so when we're in a session, I know that these feelings that she's having, they don't make any sense. They don't make any logical sense. And she cannot talk herself out of those feelings, because I'm sure she's tried. It's okay, this guy's really nice, he's very gentle, everything's okay, I'm fine, blah, blah, blah. You can do that, and it might help a little bit, but it doesn't deal with those strong negative emotions in your body that prevent you from being able to be yourself. Why not? Because these emotions are too strong, and these emotions, they come from somewhere. They were not her, oh, you're 23? Yeah, these emotions were not her 23-year-old self emotions. They were the emotions from little Zizou, you know, who was 9 years old, or from Zizou that was 18 years old, and she was reliving those feelings. So what we did is we went, well, first we connected with those emotions while we were doing the tapping. And yes, sometimes that is uncomfortable and painful, because you get to experience them. So, but you know, she experiences them throughout her life anyway, whenever an attractive guy shows up, or there's sexual tension or anything like that. So those feelings are there, whether you like it or not. You can't run away from them. So we purposely face them. So it's kind of like an exposure therapy, but not an exposure therapy where you go run up to a stranger and high five them or other ridiculous stuff, you know? Instead, you face those emotions in the comfort of your own home. And then as you bring up these emotions, you add the tapping to it. So we're, you know, my coaching is focused on provoking those emotions and then doing the tapping to neutralize and let go of those old stuck emotions, so you can process them. So these old emotions from 7-year-old Zizou can actually complete their cycle. Because emotions are like waves on the ocean. Eventually they peak, and the tapping allows them to reach the peak and then process through. And that's a very relieving thing. So then those feelings are no longer lodged or coded in your body, but they're actually processed. So you're, then when an attractive guy shows up for her, or she has some sexual tension or anything, she doesn't revert back to feeling like a 9-year-old or like a 15-year-old or whatever the case may be, because those feelings are not there anymore to be triggered, because they've been processed. Then she can just react as a 23-year-old and be free in making her decisions based upon her values. And and that process sometimes involves tears, not always. It involves feeling uncomfortable feelings like insecurity or shame or embarrassment, any kind of negative emotion really. But it's a process that involves tapping. Usually it involves quite a bit of joking around. There might be some visualization involved, and you're basically repeating a lot of what I say, and I ask you questions, you answer it, and simultaneously we're tapping. We're bringing up stuff from the past that you no longer want to hold on to, and we release it and let go of it, and there you go. And how did you feel at the end of it when you...
Right away after the session, or a couple of days after this?
All of it.
Okay, so as soon as we finished, I remember I couldn't wait to like just try to be with people and try some things with guys and everything, you know, because I felt kind of unlocked.
Unblocked, you know? Yeah. Liberated.
But still, I was still curious to see how it would be translated, you know, in
real life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I remember the next 2 or 3 days, my sleep was very
disturbed.
Yeah, disturbed. Not nightmares, but like, yeah. I mean, I guess we went very deep into this, maybe this subconscious.
And yeah, then, for
like,
sure.
Yeah. And I was prepared for that, but then, well, I don't know why, but for some reason, I mean, my dance changed, my like the way I moved and the way I was just like, you know, walking, I think, sitting, talking with people, and the will to just go to some more events alone, not just dancing ones, but like more general, you know, like going to Canggu or these kind of things, big parties, or more intimate ones with people that I don't know, go for some acro beach trips, these kind of things, and yeah, like I was not just more comfortable, but like I had like, okay, I won't say no more problems, but almost like, I mean, it would be, well, sometimes, yeah, I would feel a little bit close, but I was much more aware of it and I could like react, you know, easily. And it wasn't no more this very big shame or thing where I cannot breathe, you know, I'm like just a mummy, you know. So yeah, I was very, very happy with that. And with men, actually, yeah, I had a before and after the session, you know, because I tried to, yeah, like apply what we talked about, and also like work on my mindset and yeah, I kind of react before it goes like too much, you know. And now if I don't do something with someone, it's really because I don't want to, rather than I cannot because I'm out of control, you know. So
you're at choice now. You can choose to
totally
move forward and pursue when you're attracted. You don't have to run away from it anymore because the feelings are overwhelming you.
Yeah, totally. So, but like, either with men or with more general relations, you know, or events, or doing an interview, you know, with like I don't know how many people that I don't know and expose myself because it's quite intimidating, you know.
Yeah.
But still, like, I mean, I never could do this before with like, and my English sucks, you know, like all these things. But now I'm really like, I'm feeling yeah, like lighter and fresher, and you know, yeah. So
nice.
Yeah, and I couldn't be like more thankful and grateful because that was the more efficient way and the most efficient exercise, or like whatever you want to call it, thing to just deal better with that, because you know, I tried many things and for years, you know, I tried to go to some associations, organizations, sorority, some shitty experiences before, but like it was never that intense and that helpful in like only 3 hours, you know. I mean, I've done lots of things before, so maybe it was easier, you know, to like open myself and just like be okay to do this kind of exercise, you know, because I knew it was going to be quite tough, but still, like, it changed me literally inside, deeply, and yeah, like, I cannot be more thankful and grateful for that.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. Well, thanks for sharing. This is helpful, because other people, it's actually quite difficult because I work with clients a lot, and there are many people that make a transformation and that have an experience like this, but they're not so eager and willing to share on a video. You know, they're kind of like, hey, this is my personal thing and I don't necessarily want to share that with others. So thank you for sharing. Yeah,
my pleasure. I mean, when you asked me, I was thinking, okay. but I was like, okay, thinking, but then actually I didn't think a long time. I think I just said yes right away. And I think in a couple of seconds, but then first you helped me, so I think that's the minimum I can do, you know, it's help back. And I'm sure like there's many people in my dealing with the same struggles, so if it can help at least one people, you know, some are worse than me, some are less, but I mean I'm sure it can help at least one person, and I would be more than happy to help, even if it's very intimate, and maybe like that I'll have some friends or some people that I know they'll see this, but I really have nothing to hide, and I'm really proud of like all this journey, because I mean I think having issues and struggles is normal, like it's part of life, and
thank you,
most important thing is overcome it.
Exactly.
So
yeah, doing something about it.
Yeah.
And the good thing is you can actually do something about it, and
yes,
something that is effective and efficient and works quickly, so that you're no longer reliving your past, but you can actually be present in the moment, you can enjoy yourself, you can have enjoyable relationships, you can sit in front of a camera and talk and have a good time, and you can dance salsa. So
yeah,
what else
do you want? And some acro and
right,
yoga.
Live a good life. Yeah,
totally.
Yeah. Now it's not as easy for everyone, as this was just a single session. It happened to be a 2.5 hour session, which is uncommon. For some people it takes a longer period of time. About 35% of the people that I work with resolve their social anxiety in 3 sessions. That's 3 times 90-minute sessions. Other people I work with, sometimes they take a longer period of time. I sometimes work with 6 sessions, 9 sessions, in rarer cases, even longer than that. But the good thing is, like, each single session you progress, because after 90 minutes of tapping, regardless of however big your problem is, something will have shifted, and that shift will be permanent, because when you clean things up from the past, it'll be gone, it will not bother you anymore, and you won't be able to get upset anymore about that thing. So a single session will take, if this is your social anxiety problem, a single session will take a chunk off of your problem, and that chunk might be, in her case, like almost all of it, and in other cases it's like a little bit, and you need to do something else, and you need to do something else in order to get to free of your social anxiety. In other people it needs to be more sessions, you know, it just depends. But whenever you start applying this in the right way, and if you need to get help and you reach out for help, you do that, you take action and you actually start to release and let go of your past, then things will start to shift and change in your life. It's an amazing time. You know, we're not just living in victim of our thoughts and emotions anymore. We can take control of our brain and reconnect with our heart, and actually live liberated lives, which is very, very cool. And I like what you said, everyone has issues. It's not something to be ashamed about. It's normal. If you live anywhere in the world, especially in the Western world, you're gonna grow up with a whole bunch of issues, and now you can work through them, and as you work through them, you grow yourself internally, you become more resilient, you have more depth to you, because you've experienced the dark side, and so now, you know, you're just more well-rounded. It's, you know, this is becoming too much of a hippy dippy talk, so we're gonna end it here and dance some salsa. But I hope this has been helpful to you. And to get my free social confidence starter kit, where I teach you the technique that I've used to overcome my own social anxiety, that I've assisted Zizou with, you can go to socialanxietysolutions.com and click on the Overcome SA for Free button, if that's still the same button. But that's where you can sign up. You get 10 videos where I teach this technique to you for free in 5 of them, and they're all like 5 or 10 minutes each. You run through them easily. I teach you the technique so you can immediately start applying it to yourself and already start reducing your social anxiety. And in 5 of those videos, I actually guide you through releasing some of the most common social anxiety problems that people run into, and you can reduce those big problems there. So that's my little marketing plug at the end. Thank you very much. I'll show you where we are going, and that is there. One single person dancing salsa. So we're gonna join them and dance some salsa.
Yes.
So thank you.
Thank bye you very now. Much.
All right. Bye bye.
Amor y la costa.